assume it's not easy to fund developments all over Europe, but it's definitely more difficult in Central and Eastern Europe. But that's maybe for Jan an issue, but for investors, it's fantastic, because the development pipelines in CEE, as we have seen, are really low and probably will be even lower when we look at 2014. Vacancy rates.
Besides Warsaw.
Warsaw is the big difference. Yes. Yeah? And on the other hand, we still see a lot of outsourcing into Central and Eastern Europe. So a lot of office take-up coming from the West, even now, even more so than when we have a crisis, because there's a huge pressure to save costs. Yeah. And just one example which surprised me as well, we have a shared service center in Warsaw, which is basically outsourcing within our company for our global corporate clients, and their costs are about 10% higher than our comparable center in India, but they say the level of reliability in Warsaw is much higher. Therefore, overall for us, Warsaw is better even than India. So it just shows, and Warsaw is relatively expensive, so there's a lot now going into Hungary because the foreign decreased so much, there's lots of unemployment, so the opportunities and see just from the outsourcing point of view and being so close to Europe, the people speak all the languages compared to India, where it's difficult to find somebody speaking Hungarian, for example. So there are lots of positive aspects.
Okay, and I think that's also the reason why in the meantime you see a lot of office markets in smaller cities developing, let's say, very rapidly. When you look at Krakow, when you look at Wroclaw, when you look at the three-city region, Gdansk, Gdynia, and Sopot here, I think that's the reason why you in Warsaw at the moment it's very difficult to find skilled workforce here, because the unemployment rate in Warsaw is almost zero, I would say, here. When you go to other bigger cities in Poland, you have very good universities. Yeah. So, which means you have clearly a skilled workforce. Yeah. The cost for the workforce are much lower than in Warsaw compared to the international standard as well. So, which makes it at the moment also attractive, not only for retail developers but also for office developers, to develop new offices in smaller cities like Krakow, Poznan, Wroclaw, Tri-City. Yeah. It does make sense. The only question here is, at the end, will they get their exit, the exit they're expecting? Will investors be willing to look outside of Warsaw? If you ask me, they should. They clearly should. Because when you look at the office pipeline under construction in Warsaw, some say it's between 500 and 700,000 square meters. It very much depends which buildings you really take into consideration. Here, if you take the spire, for example, from Gelamco, which would be 100,000 square meters. But as far as I know, there's not one single square meter pre-let at the moment, and nobody would finance a 100,000 development in Warsaw on spec basis.
Yet they started work.
But they started work, with the excavation, something like that, you know. So, okay, they can say, we have already started. Yeah, but I personally doubt that they will build 100,000 on pure spec basis. Also, I personally doubt, without knowing their balance sheets, but I mean, 100,000 square meters requires 200, 250 million euros. Pure equity? Most likely not.
We don't see the investors yet for those secondary cities. We will see how it goes. But I always use as an example the second biggest city in Austria, which is Graz. And there was never an international investor going to Graz into offices. Retail is obviously different and industrial is different, but investors for offices outside the capital cities and CEE at the moment at least is really...
It is a problem. In the past you saw even the German open-ended funds buying outside of Warsaw office buildings. Yeah? And I mean, once again, if you have one or two, three very good office buildings in smaller cities, not a size like 60,000 per office building, but 20,000, 25,000, if it's a good location, good quality, and if you assess the market right, you will find definitely the tenants. The question is not on 20, 25 euros per square meter, but maybe on 10, 12, 14. Yeah, and that's perfectly achievable. On the other hand side, if you do the wrong choice, like in Łódź, for example, there are two or three office buildings which are more or less completely vacant, and they do not find their tenants because they clearly, let's say, over-assess the market.